The police are now here, but their presence has done little to bring a sense of security. No one has returned to what was once a busy spare parts market. Shops remain closed, a week after 13 people were gunned down by unknown assailants. It was the worst incident in over a week of shootings that was sparked by political tensions. Karachi is used to periodic bursts of political violence, but the latest wave of targeted killings has still not stopped. Many people have lost faith in the security forces. Some 30,000 police guard Pakistan's largest city. Approximately one-third is assigned to protect officials. There are plans to recruit an extra 3,000 men, but some say that's not the answer.
There are enough rangers and there are enough police forces. The question is of empowering them. Right. If you do not empower them, then you're not going to get any results. And when I say empower them, is that if a person is caught, then he must be prosecuted. He must be charged and prosecuted. It's not good for any society if a man comes from a political party, he's caught, and the political party comes in and takes him out.
Some accused killers like Ishtiaq confirm ties to political parties. He wasn't involved in the latest spate of shootings, but in this video provided to us by Karachi security officials, Ishtiaq says he is a member of the MQM party. Police at times do make arrests and confiscate illegal arms, but too often gangs and local mafias appear above the law.
This city needs de-weaponization. De-weaponization is a must. There's no city in the world that is so much awash with weapons as Karachi.
Mary Namtaj knows that fact all too well. Too scared to show his face on camera, this young boy witnessed the market shootings. It is a political battle, he tells me, and Karachi will be secure when politicians are at peace. Zana Khudr, Al Jazeera, Karachi.